Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. For those who haven't met me yet, my name is Mo, and we've had a pretty good surge of new subscribers lately due to our popular cabin build that we've done this past year. We're now upwards of 600,000 plus views on that video. So we thank you for that, and hopefully we'll get to 1 million, hopefully we'll get to 10 million. And if we get to even more, even better, but, you know, wishful thinking, you know, as they say. But I'll be happy if we can get to 1 million, and I think we actually probably will. It looks like we probably will. We're getting good views on that. We're getting a good number of subscribers, so welcome to all of you. Again, my name is Mo, M-O. Spelled a little different, and it's short for my real name. We always try to keep a certain level of privacy on this channel. My wife's name's Pink, and obviously that's just the name that she's been going by ever since she was a kid, even though that is not actually her real name. So our real names are so far a secret. I don't know if many of you know, I'm not originally from the United States. I am originally from Italy. I grew up there. I came to the United States at the age of 15 with my mother and my stepdad. This is our main cabin behind me right here. We've done a lot of work to it since we moved in. We bought this for $43,000 on just over 4 acres of land in southwestern Virginia. Where I spent most of my life. I spent most of my life, adult life in Virginia, in Northern Virginia, to be exact. But this is a lot different, obviously, but we love it. My wife and I, Pink and I, love it. And but you can see right here, the tree is just right above the cabin. So we have to get that taken down, and we're making plans for it. You know, it's not inexpensive. It's pretty expensive to take down those large trees, especially when they're close to homes. They have to have insurance. It's a big liability for them. It's not like they can just, you know, down the tree, but it's right on above our cabin. So we want to get it taken down.
Oh, look, Pink is out. Hey, baby. Hi. How are you doing? What are you doing with your... Let me see your socks.
I know.
Let me see.
It's cheating semester.
That's perfect. That's a perfect match.
Thank you.
When you think about it. You were taking a break?
Yeah, I'm just taking a break.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pink works from home, so, you know, she just has to be inside, unfortunately, a lot of the time. But
yeah, so.
Yeah, it works. It
doing a stretch.
Bit. Yeah. So we're hopeful. We've been talking because it looks like the neighbor's trailer is getting moved out of here. So we're very, very excited about that.
Yes. Always nice.
We're very excited about it. We're very excited about that trailer getting moved out of here. Yes. Because it was too close to our property to begin with, I always thought. And we had no privacy. They didn't either, really. I mean, but now they've already moved out, like, 2 months ago, and yeah. It looks like somebody is getting ready to pick it up. So we're excited about that.
Hi, Mama.
What was I going to say, guys? We're building. I've been busy. I've been very, very busy. We're close to redoing our kitchen. We're working on doing that, and so we're saving up for that. We have already taken out the stove. We have replaced our stove. We were able to find a used one for, you're not going to believe it, $45. And it was a brand new gas stove. Brand new. You'll see it in a later video when we redo our kitchen. Brand new stove. Never used. It was crazy. Yes, we had to go get it. We had to load it ourselves. And I unloaded it on my own. I don't have a video of it. You guys, I might have mentioned this before, and one thing you have to understand, I can't video everything, and because I have so much to do, and it takes so much of my time to move the camera constantly back and forth. So, but I do try to get it, but a lot of the things I do off camera are like unloading the stove and bringing it inside with no help. Pink wasn't around at the moment, but I did it, right, Pink?
Yes.
And so when there's a will, there's a way, you know. I'm not one for making excuses. I'm definitely not one of those people. Quite the opposite. Right now we're in the process of redoing the interior of our cabin. We haven't been getting a lot of interest on those videos. That's why we kind of like slow down and, you know, from putting out so much about that, because, we haven't been moving too fast. Again, I've had some injuries. I've had some tennis elbow issues on both my elbows.
And golf.
And golf.
Golfer's elbow.
I have both on the left, on my left elbow, I have both. Golfer's elbow and tennis elbow. So anyways, I've been coping with that and dealing with it, but I'm still doing stuff because I have to. I can't just sit on my butt and do nothing, you know. Things need to be done and life goes on, so I do it. And like I said, I'm not one for making excuses. It's just not what our channel is about. We're all about self-reliance and getting things done on this channel.
Yeah. Do what you can, when you can, with what you have.
Right. And not to show off. It's just the way it is. Right now, like I said, we're working on the interior. We just put on a couple of doors. And let us show you. Let's show the front one first, baby.
This is our stove that's getting ready to get retired.
We need to bring it to the recycling center.
It's just been sitting out for about a month, I guess, and now it's collecting. The chickens land on it, and it's nasty, but it's fine. This is the front door that I had kind of rebuilt last year, or the first year we moved in, actually, 2 years ago. And then over here is our new front door. I have to work on it a little bit more. I had to get creative because it was a used door. I had to really do a lot of patching and double hinge the top.
It was smaller than the measurements they had originally posted that it was. So,
And you can see the opening behind you, how much it just opens up the entire cabin, walking in. And then the stove is right there. Now you can see the stove better. And, you know, the TV is mounted on the wall, so it's out of the way. And the wall there, that's the blue one, we removed the paneling off of that. Mm-hmm. And now we have to patch it and then repaint it. So that's what we're going to do. But, you know, we're still in the process. And then the last thing we'll do is our floors.
Yes.
But we got big plans, and our little cabin here is going to turn out to be a pretty nice little cozy little cabin, little cottage, right, baby?
Yeah, it already has so much better chi and energy flow with all the openings and the doors
right.
and everything.
Right. We'll go back and show him the other door.
Okay.
We're getting ready to put the tape and stucco all the drywall. But the door, we put the locks in, and everything works nice and smooth. And we were fortunate. We picked this door up for $50, and she came with the frame and everything. So I put the top lock on it as well. I had to drill the holes and do all that naturally. And let's see, it's got the bottom plate and everything came with, and it's on frame. And then I put the trim all around the edges and painted it. I have to go back and fill in a little bit more of those holes and paint it one more time. But other than that, and then the door hasn't even been painted yet. I just kind of patched it. This corner here was a little loose. Remember, I told you it was $40 for this door. So I put like caulking all underneath it and on the edges, and then it's ready for painting now because, like I said, it was a little loose. But the door is perfect, nice and tight, and worked out great. We're very happy. It gives us full access now to our rear deck. And that's our enclosed sunroom that we have videos on all of this. Our grass is better than it's ever been since we moved here. We had garbage mountains and mountains and mountains of garbage all over our backyard that we had to dispose of. But it took a year, an entire year, to get all that done. But you know, it's recovering. So right now, it still needs to. We have to put grass seed. We reclaim a lot of the back of the woods back in there. And the cabin that we built is right here behind those trees. And then now we're planning on building another cabin right down here by the creek. And I have to wait because there are yellow jackets there now. I already got stung going there, so I'm going to wait till the fall, till they're gone, and then I can work. I can get in there and work. We just removed a bunch of kudzu. I don't know if you guys are familiar. It's an invasive weed from Asia, from Japan and China, I think. So we killed and removed quite a bit of it.
And I cut down some trees that needed to be taken down. And we're going to be using them for projects. They're very straight. They're beautiful poplar trees, trunks. And we're going to use them for like cabin builds. What we want to do here, guys, in case you didn't, maybe some of you didn't quite understand, or we didn't explain it enough times or well enough. But what we're trying to do is create our own compound over here. We want to have a number of cabins for numerous reasons. First of all, I enjoy building. I enjoy building cabins and any kind of building, really, for that matter. We also want to have a way, maybe someday, if need be, have some kind of revenue, because there, we have a driveway that, I don't know, I don't think we showed it yet, that goes from the side, the back side of the property, that goes to the cabin over here that we built. And then from there, you could actually walk to the future cabin as well, or other cabins for that matter, without having to go through our own property here. People could just park back here, plenty of parking, and the driveway kind of goes into the woods, and then you can just walk through, you know, the trees, just maybe 30 feet, and you're where you need to be, without having, again, to go through our property, which is, when you have a Airbnb, I think it's important to give people as much privacy as possible, especially if they're coming to stay at a cabin. It's very peaceful over here, it's very quiet.
These are our hazelnuts. And you see they're grown. Now, our goats had gotten out and they ate most of them, but they're recovering. And also the beetles had a go at them, but they're recovering. You can see there, beetle holes. You see a lot of new foliage and leaves. It really wants to grow. We've had a lot of rain. We've been blessed. This one's the one that took the most beating, but it's coming back. It's doing all right. It's still got nice new growth coming in, so it'll be okay. Just a little slower, just on the same. You know, again, they got eaten up by our goats, so now we have to wait for them to recover. But we got some figs. We're going to give them some water tonight and possibly see if we can put them somewhere. We have figs everywhere. I already have 6 figs in the ground, plus whatever these. So
the idea, Pink has wanting to get as many figs from different parts of the world, Middle East, Italy, Spain, just different parts, South America, different parts of the world, and perhaps maybe have a market, because we have a lot of local markets here. We could go and sell our figs to the local markets. So that is one of the reasons why we're planting so many figs. And we do love figs. We enjoy the figs. We have a lot of Italian, sweet Italian figs as well. So I guess I'll go inside now. Again, we just wanted to give everybody an update and sort of give you a feel for us and how we like to do things and what's been happening and what's going on. And when we first started out, we were doing all kinds of projects with pallets, with trees, cheap fencing, just whatever we could use without spending money. And that's kind of how we built the channel. Unintentionally, but just because of circumstances, and it's fine, you know. We're doing it. We're doing it slowly, but we're doing it. Even with my elbow issue, I'm lifting things. I'm moving things. I have to do the things I have to do, and I do them. And so, you know, there will be videos. There just may not be a cabin build video in the very near future because we're busy here right now. And so all of our efforts and our money is going into our main cabin because this is where we live, naturally, right? So we have to get this done first. After we get this done, then we'll start focusing on building some more cabins back here in our backwoods, okay? Because Mo loves to build, and so it's just something I really don't want to quit. It keeps me young, it keeps my arthritis in check. It helps with that. It helps with my degenerative bone disease. It helps with my herniated discs. I've had two surgeries, one on my right shoulder about a decade ago, and pretty before that, I had a knee surgery as well. So, but you know, again, I don't make excuses, and that's what our channel is about. Doing things on a budget, buying things on a budget. And sometimes we get lucky. We bought a whole set of four oak chairs, beautiful, and a solid maple, very heavy table. All the whole set, four chairs and the table for $40. Again, it was like $40. It seems everything we've been buying is $40. Even the windows, usually they're like between $10 and $50 is what we usually pay per window when we buy them. And our doors, $40 for one, and the other one was $50. Everything's going to get done, but Mo's only got two hands, and so I have to prioritize right now and, you know, get our house finished. So that's the plan. We finish here. Once we finish here, we'll have a start-to-finish video of the entire cabin, from when we started to the end and what we've done. We've had already one. We put out a video, our 3-year anniversary video. It could have been a better video. I could have done a better job with it, with the editing, because I do all of my own editing. We don't use any outside sources for anything. Everything that we do on this channel, we do ourselves, okay? Every single thing, whether it's plumbing, electrical, building, cutting the grass, tearing things down, doesn't matter. We do it all ourselves because that's what we're all about. We're all about self-sufficiency, self-reliance. That is what I think the world that we live in right now, we're coming to a point where it is imperative for people to be more self-reliant, rely on themselves, not and with food sources. We have a little bit of a garden. I haven't showed you, but we have some basil growing and some zucchini and some beans. Nothing much, but, you know, we did a little because we've been busy, and we've been busy with other things. So we haven't been able to be in our third year into this very rundown $43,000 property. We haven't been able to dedicate a lot of time to other things that we need to prioritize on, which is like a garden. But we started boxes and we're ready. We have plenty of manure now and compost. So we're going to be using that. The things that we did plant are doing fantastic with our new compost from our goats and rabbits and chickens. They're doing absolutely fantastic. Mostly from the rabbits, I would say, and the goats. Not a lot of the chicken. Because they're kind of free-ranging a lot, our chickens, so their poops are everywhere. We're glad we've been able to have all this grass grow back here again, because now we have a couple of wild tomatoes growing over there in the middle of it, believe it or not. We're going to get that new weed eater. I'll be able to clean all this up, and we'll have grass again because the goats were eating everything. And so we wanted to get, again, we want to get all the animals as far away from our main cabin as possible and cut down on the mosquito and the fly population because we're infested. And plus we're under this huge oak tree, so that makes it even worse. But I'll do what I can to minimize the problem, you know? All right? Okay, guys, well, Thanks for watching, and we'll be back real soon with more videos and more, you know, project videos. But this was just an update, and I know a lot of you appreciate it because a lot of you have been missing seeing our videos. So here it is. Love you guys. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one. Take care.